Why so glum?
Well, every morning I wake up and I announce my intention to have as much fun as humanly and spiritually possible.
For the sake of the recording, are you wanting to describe what has taken place here?
Oh, sure. I've become a clown, and this will be a rampage of appreciation. I go everywhere I go, and I wear this beautiful wig, and whether it's a sporting event or the bank, these rainbow colors give everybody a smile, and I get a lot of attention, and that's great, and I'm making more money than I've ever made in my entire life, and I'm interacting with friends far more joy and fun every day than I could ever possibly appreciate. And my relationship with my parents, I just had a birthday, and I had the funniest birthday party that I've ever had. And it's been wonderful. And I noticed that in my expansion, I'm still contracting from time to time. And that can be uncomfortable. And I'm curious to know about people who have walked the earth, who have come to be known as masters, or folks who have seemed to have achieved some sort of permanent connection to source energy. And I've heard these stories, and they seem to be sort of living this heaven on earth experience where the way that it comes off to me is that they don't experience contrast at all. I'm curious to know if they're just really magnificent managers of contrast, and if that's as good as that can get, or if there is some kind of lasting, permanent connection that can be achieved.
Well, there will always be contrast. There is even contrast in non-physical. Mm. But the contrast in non-physical is so infinitesimal that you would not be able to discern it from your physical format. Mm-hmm. And so it is possible that what you are describing as someone who is having no contrast is just someone who's refined their ability to discern it and adjust to it, but from your vantage point it looks as if they have not any. Mm-hmm. So what we've been talking about here today, about being aware of the way you feel and then reaching for the better thought, that really is the process that will take you to this place that you want to go. Mm-hmm. We do not believe that you would want it to ever be that you were unaware of the hot stove. Mm-hmm. We think that your ability to know that the stove is hot and therefore your ability to utilize it in ways that are advantageous to you is a very important thing. There are thoughts that you would call beneficial, and there are thoughts that you would call not beneficial, and many of the thoughts that you would call not beneficial, someone else might call beneficial. In other words, you cannot possibly sort it out, mm-hmm. but you can find the alignment between your thoughts, and that's really what your emotions are about. So the more aware you are of the way you feel, mm-hmm. and the stronger your determination to feel good, then the more you will catch your vibrational variances at the earlier subtle stages, and the more you will bring yourself into alignment about them. And so what begins to happen is, even though your vibrational average mm-hmm. is raising, because it represents your day-to-day experience, you are not so aware of, it's sort of like getting into a very hot bathtub, and then it feels all right after you've been there for a while, you acclimate to it. Mm-hmm. So the same sort of thing happens. As you acclimate to the higher vibration, it may begin to just feel normal to you, even though it's considerably different than where you have been formerly. Mm-hmm. And so as you maintain that, then there will always be contrast that will help you reach to another place and reach to another place. So you ask many questions here, and we want to give you many answers all at once. No one ever stands still. And even these masters that you are talking about are always reaching. We think that mm-hmm. what you are seeing within them is that they are always, not always, but usually reaching for the thought that feels better, reaching for the thought that feels better, where most people, you see, are reaching here, reaching for the thought that feels better, but then beating the drum of what feels worse. The masters that you are describing are people that have developed patterns of self-discipline where they are more conscientious about putting their thoughts in a place that is beneficial to them. That's the biggest difference. There will always be contrast. You will always be able to look out into the world and see things not wanted or that are not wanted by you. Mm-hmm. But from your broader perspective, you would not change that. You would not try to take away those things just because you do not want them. Instead, you learn to adjust your vibration so that what comes to you is pleasing to you. Mm-hmm. We think that the true masters are those who have discovered their own techniques And there are a lot of different ones that work for different people. Their own technique of achieving their own vibrational harmony. Mm-hmm. That's really what it is all about.
Thank you.
You might meet someone who, by your standards, is asking for very little. And they are in that perfect place of balance because what they're asking for and what they've achieved stays very close to the same vibration. And you might see someone else who is really far-reaching into things that they do not have and having more of a roller coaster ride. And we say, no one but them can understand the perfection of their experience. Mm-hmm. The other day, Esther was watching someone living a very different experience from her own, and they were expressing their contentment with where they are. And as Esther was enjoying the contentment that they were expressing, for a moment she thought, maybe I shouldn't reach so far. And then she realized that if she didn't reach far, she would feel very much discord. In other words, she realized she could not live their life and feel the ease that they live in their life, because the range between her desire and where she is would not allow her that, you see. Mm-hmm. And so the master is the one who has found the way to align with his desire. And nobody else gets to decide where that desire should be, and nobody else can tell when he's clicked into it, you see. Mm-hmm. Just like you with your hair. In other words, there are so many people who would not do that. But it doesn't make them right, and it doesn't make you wrong. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yes, indeed. Mm. Yes, indeed.